Do you know that Indian and Nepalese students have returned the quickest since Australia's borders reopened? International students are returning to Australia after almost 2 years of closed borders. The number of international students in Australia increased by 29,856 in the first 6 weeks after the Australian government opened the border to them in mid-December. For detailed information, watch this video till the end and yes, like and share the video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Warm welcome from Brain Drain Consultants to our immigration information and news channel, A2Z Immigration Updates. International students are a vital part of the workforce in many industries. In particular, many work in hospitality and carer roles. The Australian government is trying to entice international students to return by offering visa refunds and easing limits on their access to the workforce. These temporary arrangements highlight the sometimes uneasy relationship between international education, migration and the workforce. The loosening of border restrictions in December 2021 has reversed the steady decline in international students. At its lowest point, there were 248,750 international students in Australia. This was a fall of about 57% compared to before the pandemic, and the lowest level since 2007. Since the borders reopened, students have returned to Australia in larger numbers from some countries than others. The numbers of students from India and Nepal have increased the most. Students from these two countries account for over 50% of the increase in the past 6 weeks. One reason students are returning at different rates may be due to the labor market. According to 2016 census data, Indian and Nepalese students are much more likely to be part of the workforce. About 78% of Indian and 87% of Nepalese students are employed in the Australian workforce. The government's efforts to get international students back to Australia more quickly highlights how important their labor is to many parts of the economy. The 2016 census showed current and recently graduated international students made up about 2% of the total labor force. This student workforce is concentrated in areas reporting shortages. Before the pandemic, about 15% of waiters, 12% of kitchen hands and 10% of cooks and chefs were current or recently graduated international students. About 11% of commercial cleaners were current or recent international students. These occupations have faced widespread difficulties in finding staff. Many other occupations where the pre-pandemic workforce included large numbers of international students are recording vacancies at well above pre-pandemic levels. Access to the Australian labour market has been a controversial aspect of international education. International students are required to demonstrate they are a genuine student, and not using a student visa to enter the country primarily to work. Yet the reasons for international students to select Australia as a destination are varied and complex. The ability to work is an important consideration. Australia uses access to the labour market to compete with other countries for students. In 2008, Australia removed the need for students to apply for a separate work visa. International students have been able to work 20 hours a week. That limit has now been lifted until at least April 2022. Following the 2011 Knight Review, many international students have been able to apply for a post-study visa. This lets them work in Australia for between 1 and 5 years after finishing their course. Competitor countries are also using post-study work rights to attract a bigger share of international enrolments. The need to temporarily loosen work restrictions shows it is not just universities that rely on international students. Many Australians will benefit from their labour. In welcoming international students back to the country, it is important to ensure their rights are protected. These students can be particularly vulnerable to exploitation in the workplace. Current visa arrangements can encourage international students to cycle through cheap courses so they can stay in Australia. As international education recovers, a better understanding of the link between international education, migration and employment can help inform policy that protects everyone's interests in the sector. We hope you appreciate our efforts to provide important and accurate immigration information. Please share your feedback and suggestions in the comments section. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel to show your support, and yes, don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you for your valuable time, and we hope to see you again soon with another video. If you need any further assistance or want to discuss anything related to your immigration dreams, then you can book an expert consultation session with our team of registered migration consultants.